Welcome to this Angular Skeleton Component tutorial. With this Syncfusion Angular Skeleton Component, you can show a preview of how a page is going to be displayed with a shimmer effect. It improves the user experience by informing users of ongoing processes. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app, add the Angular Skeleton Component, and implement its different shapes, animations, and customization features. Let me start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on Google Chrome. To create a project in Angular, I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the command npm install -g at angular/cli. I use the ng new project name command and name my project my Angular app. I am going to create a project with a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started. Now let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular Skeleton component, I need to use the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-notifications --save. This will install the package along with its dependencies. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So I open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. Now, the application is configured to use Syncfusion Angular components. Next, I navigate to the app component TS file and import the skeleton module from the Syncfusion Angular notifications package. I register it within the imports array of the component section. To apply styles to the skeleton component, I navigate to the styles CSS and add the necessary references by importing the material theme. To add the Angular skeleton component, I open the app component HTML file and remove its default content first. I add a division element with a container class to align the skeleton component. Before moving to the component rendering, let me show you the layout design that I'm going to use in this example. Here you can see a card which has a profile picture, profile description, and content. Later in this video, I will show you how to design the skeleton layout of this card. First, let's design this card using the Syncfusion card component. I install the Syncfusion Angular Layouts package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-layouts --save. I add a division element with a class eCard. This predefined class will add all the necessary CSS styles required to display this div as a Syncfusion Angular card component. Now I am importing layout styles into the CSS file. Within the division element, I add a set of HTML elements to add images and content for the card. To apply styles, I add the container and predefined CSS class eCard with styles for margin, width, padding, and line height. Next, I run the application using the command ngserve. Here, the card is rendered with a profile picture, name, and image. Now I will show you how to display a skeleton layout for this card content. First, I am going to display the skeleton for this image element. I comment out the profile picture image element and add the EJS skeleton tag. I set its height and width to 60 pixels. Checking now, the skeleton is rendered for the profile picture, and its default shape is text. The other shapes available are circle, square, and rectangle. To render a circular skeleton, I can use the shape property and set its value to circle. For this shape, the height property is not required, so I remove it. Look, the circular skeleton renders for the profile picture. Next, I am going to add a skeleton for this profile description. I comment out the label tag and add this skeleton component with its basic width and height properties. The skeleton now renders for the profile description. Similarly, I comment out the image tag and add the skeleton component for the content. To display the content skeleton in a rectangle, I set the shape property to rectangle with an appropriate height and width. Checking now, a rectangular skeleton is rendered for the content. Next, let me show you how to implement this skeleton as a loading indicator for this card. I want to show the skeleton for 3.5 seconds as a loading indicator and then load the content of the card. To do that, I remove the elements that are commented out previously. This block will render before the card content gets loaded. I define the NG template tag with the reference ID card block. Then I add the card layout here. Then in the app component TS file, I define the variable isDataLoading and set its value to true to show the skeleton component initially. To display the card layout after 3.5 seconds, I define NG on init method. I call the setTimeout method with a time interval of 3.5 seconds. I set isDataLoading value to false. To load the skeleton initially, I add an NG if condition and check if isDataLoading is true. If so, the skeleton will render, otherwise the card block will render. To use this NG if directive, I import it from Angular Common Package and register it in the imports array of the component section in the app component ES file. See, when I refresh a page, initially the skeleton is shown for 3.5 seconds and then the card layout is loaded. By default, the wave animation effect is applied to the skeleton. The component also supports the fade and pulse animation effects. I will show you the pulse effect. I include the shimmer effect property with appropriate value. I apply the same effect to the other two skeletons. Check, the pulse effect is visible in the skeleton. Finally, I will show you how to customize the skeleton. I want to change the background color of the skeleton. To do that, I add the CSS class property and assign the class name custom. Similarly, I add the CSS class property to the other skeletons. In the style CSS file, I define the custom CSS class and add the background color property. You can see the background color of the skeleton has changed. In this video, I have shown you how to create an Angular app, add the Syncfusion Angular skeleton component to it, and use a few of its basic features such as using different shapes, animations, and customization options. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link given in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular components through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like it and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.